Derek, the Bank of Canada is set to meet the beginning of April. The expectation is that the central bank will hold and begin to cut rates in June. Is your forecast in line with the expectation?
Partly. I think that they will hold, but I don't think that they're going to tee up a cut as soon as the June meeting. We have September for our first rate cut from the Bank of Canada and 75 points worth of reduction by the end of the year. And so we're a little bit later than consensus on markets or pricing rates now.
Most recently, the Bank of Canada released its business outlook survey. Some of the biggest takeaways there.
I think the business and the consumer survey on balance carried a mixed message. Consumers are still saying that they don't believe the Bank of Canada will be able to achieve its 2% inflation target, even as far out as 5 years from now. Businesses are a little bit more optimistic. They think that inflation could be somewhere in the range of 2.5 to 3%, depending upon what time period we're looking, how far off into the future. And so the bank still has some work to do, particularly to convince consumers that they are intent on getting inflation down to the Bank of Canada's 2% inflation target.
Let's talk about those two components from the consumer side and from the business angle. Maybe on the consumer side, I found it interesting that even though housing affordability and availability is still a key, I guess, topic of conversation, the intentions to purchase homes seems to be on the rise. Does that surprise you?
I think there are two things going on there. For one thing, I think all the sidelined first-time home buyers who were pushed out of the market when prices got crazy last spring have been spending the past year amassing bigger down payments to capitalize upon slightly cheaper prices. And so that's money on the sidelines just waiting to come back in. I think the second thing here is this massive surge of immigration, the 2 million people who arrived over the past couple of years. First, many of them go into the rental market and fed rent inflation, but at the same time, they're still signaling a very strong desire to buy their own places going forward. And I think that's the other part of the puzzle that's probably more dominant in terms of home buying appetite going forward.
When you take a look at the Canadian business landscape, investment intentions had declined. And we've often talked about investment in our country. What do you think it's going to take for us to, I guess, see a greater appetite for investment?
It's a really tricky issue with a lot of moving parts in terms of what drives business investment. And so I think the debate has almost become too polarized in some respects. I can see the business approach that says that, well, we have a weak currency. It's costly to import most of our machinery and equipment from the United States because of that. And we've also lost a relative tax advantage on the corporate side of the picture since 2018 compared to the United States and elsewhere. And so the reward to investing in Canada versus the United States has been negatively impacted. And from a public policy standpoint, we've favored labor over capital with very, very generous job market supports for years now. However, I can also see the opposite argument from public policymakers that say that, well, we have decades of history here where businesses tend to underinvest and spend too little on technology adoption and spend too little on research and development. And so it's a complicated mixture, I think, with a lot of different parties responsible for this mess.
It's budget season. Provincial budgets have been rolling out. We're still waiting on the big one, the federal budget, to be tabled in April. Do you think the federal government will take into account any of this data? What do you think they're watching?
Well, I think what they should be looking at is to toe the line on spending increases in recognition of the fact that every time we go through a budget season or the fall fiscal updates, we heap on more spending, which adds further stimulus to the Canadian economy, which slows the extent to which we can build up a little bit of slack or excess supply in the economy that would be disinflationary to bring inflation down, and therefore we can get to rate cuts. And what we've gone through just now is a provincial budget season with 9 out of 10 provinces issuing their budgets, adding even more spending. And so the Bank of Canada will probably come in and say that government spending is going to contribute 1 to 1.5 percentage points to GDP growth this year, probably something similar next year, which is about double what they had previously expected. Therefore, what's the big rush to cut interest rates?
Lastly, there seems to be a notion that recession fears have abated. Do you think the same? Are we out of the woods?
I think it's perhaps in some respects a bit premature to say totally out of the woods, but we've always been in the soft landing camp on the more optimistic side of the debate. And I think that the evidence we've gotten more recently is supportive of that view. And so, for example, governments priming the economy still with extra spending, that supports growth. Secondly, we've seen oil prices jump by about $20 a barrel since last December. And so that tends to favor the Canadian economy. It means it's a trickle-down effect throughout the whole economy that benefits many people's incomes. And so that's an added contribution here. And the U.S. economy has our back. They continue to be resilient. And so that's a good safety net for the Canadian economy. So I still think that there are a number of positives here to emphasize for Canada.